My greetings to all the viewers. I am Sanjay. Today I'll be presenting before you a non-invasive ventilator called Swasth Vayu, which has been jointly developed by CSIR, NAL and Apollo Computing Laboratories Private Limited. As you know, the world is going through a very difficult phase because of the COVID-19 pandemic, which has affected almost all the countries in the world, killing more than hundreds of thousands of people. So there is a growing need of ventilators to treat the COVID-19 patients. So we require a very large number of ventilators for this purpose. To meet this task, National Aerospace Laboratory, CSIR, NAL, which is a government approved R&D lab, and Apollo Computing Laboratories Private Limited, they have jointly developed a unique non-invasive ventilator, which is state-of-the-art device, which is microcontroller based, and it's non-invasive BiPAP ventilator. This machine has been certified by NABL accredited lab after undergoing extensive biomedical tests and clinical trials. As you can see on the screen, for the electrical safety, it has been certified by Transcal Engineers and TUV, which is an international agency. Then for the compliance of ROHS directive and EC directive, it has been certified by Optimum Certifications Inc., which is a Scottish company. The extensive biomedical tests and clinical trials have been carried out mainly in three hospitals at Hyderabad: Sai Krishna Neuro Hospital, Indo-US Super Speciality Hospital and Jubilee Hospital, and three hospitals in Bangalore: Fortis, Aster CMI and Mediscope. So ladies and gentlemen, I'll briefly explain you about this device called Swasth Vayu. As you can see, it's a very portable equipment which is just like a small briefcase weighing about 3 kg with all its accessories. Just to tell you about the subcomponents of this device, I'll start from the rear side. Rear side, we have got a point here where the power cord can be connected, that SMPS, and it runs on 24 volt DC, which is getting converted from the commercial supply through a SMPS adapter. Then this is a power on off button, which is basically to switch on or switch off the machine. This is the inlet point where there is a filter, you can see white filter, that is called HEPA filter. It's nothing but high efficiency particulate air filter, which removes almost 99.99% of the particles of 0.3 micron size. This is very easy to change. This is what is called the HEPA filter. We just have to remove these four screws and put it here. From the side, you can see this is a bellow and this is a HME plus BV filter. HME is heat moisture exchanger and BV is bacterial viral filter. This is again very easy to remove and change. On the front side, you have a outlet port here. Then there is a LCD display and user interface buttons. We do have a SD card slot here where an SD card can be inserted to store the information which are there during the usage of this machine. As far as the accessories are concerned, this is a flexible hose which gets connected here at the outlet port. On the other side of this flexible hose, we have got a T manifold to which is connected a non-vented mask. It is not vented to the atmosphere, so it prevents virus coming inside or going out from here. Then there is another HME plus BV filter in the exhale circuit which takes care of the contamination which are present during exhaling. All these accessories that you can see, this flexible hose, T manifold, HME plus BV filter, mask, and this HME plus BV filter which is there in the intermediate stage, all these are to be mandatorily changed from patient to patient. Now, as far as this operation of this machine is concerned, it works on three modes basically: one manual and two automatic modes. The manual mode is called CPAP mode, in which it provides a continuous fixed positive airway pressure to the patient. In timed mode, it provides timed breath delivery, and in spontaneous timed mode, it provides either spontaneous or timed breath delivery to the patient. Now, to use this machine, we have to do certain device setup. First of all, before using this machine for any patient, we need to ensure that all these accessories have been changed and put fresh ones. Then we switch on the machine from the power on a button. Then on the front side, as you can see, first you need to go to the settings. The doctor would have already decided for a particular patient which mode he is supposed to use. Now, as per that mode, there are certain parameters which are to be set, which are there in the user manual of this equipment. So he has to go to the settings and set the parameters. After setting the parameters, then he goes to the mode and selects whichever mode he wants to use. The moment he presses that, suppose he selects CPAP mode, then he presses the button, the machine runs now. Then he can, during running, he can go to therapy and see the parameters, various parameters which have been already set, and depending on the patient's progress, if required, he may change the parameters, he may increase or decrease that. Now, once the operation is over, it is very important that you have to go to the settings. Then you have to go to the mode and you have to select the standby mode. Then only you should switch off the machine. So this is very safe. You should not switch off the machine while the machine is operating in a different mode. You should first bring it to the standby mode, then you should switch off. Now I'll briefly tell you how this Swasth Vayu ventilator operates. As you can see, the air is coming from the inlet port. It goes through the HEPA filter, already I have explained, at the input. Then at the interstage, it goes through the HME plus BV filter. The air comes out from here. Then from the outlet, it goes to the T manifold, which is a specially designed tube and this manifold. And then through non-vented mask, the air goes to the patient. This is to be worn tightly by the patient. If required, if the patient condition so warrants, then there is a nozzle here to which we can connect an oxygen concentrator. That is an optional equipment if there is a requirement. Now, I will tell you the advantages of this equipment and some of its special features which are not there in other equipment of its class. First of all, as I told you, it's compact, it's easy to use, and it is affordable. Air is entering through the inlet port through HEPA filter. It is passing through the HME plus BV filter, and then it is going through a specially designed manifold to the patient through a non-vented mask. So by this, the pressurized air, or if required, oxygen also along with the air, is supplied to the patient without any contamination, because the filtration is taken place at every stage. So because of this, the contamination of the surrounding which is available, that is blocked in the airway, and what the patient gets is the clean and healthy air. Now the HME plus BV filter at the T manifold, this is specially incorporated to take care of the contamination which is likely to be there in the exhale circuit, so that it prevents any virus or any other contamination getting outside into the environment. So as a result, what happens? The virus spread to the surroundings is totally avoided. Additionally, this equipment has got 6 alarm buzzers, which is basically to indicate the medical personnel who are treating the COVID-19 patients about the patient condition. These alarms are designed based on a certain algorithm. And the last but not the least, this equipment has got an inbuilt lithium ion battery which provides us more than 2 hours of battery backup. Now I'll tell you about the uses of this particular device. As I had told you, this particular ventilator was designed and developed keeping the COVID-19 situation in mind, but it also can be used for non-COVID situation. So for COVID situation, it can be used in wards, dispensaries, makeshift hospitals, and even at homes. Because of its size, it can be carried anywhere. For the non-COVID situation, patients who are suffering from lung disease, sleep apnea, or respiratory weakness, they all can be treated by this device. We have got elaborate R&D infrastructure based at Hyderabad, which consists of assembly and testing facility, design and development center, and environmental test facility. We have got a world-class production facility to meet the demand which is there and produce sufficient number of devices to provide to the users. To summarize, I can say that this is first time in the world that a non-invasive ventilator of its class has got three filters, that is filter at inlet stage, at interstage, and at exhalation stage, which is unique. This provides pressurized clean air to the patient without any contamination through a non-vented mask. Therefore, the endanger of healthcare workers is totally avoided when they are treating the COVID-19 patients. It has got 6 alarms, which includes low battery alarm also, which gives an indication to the healthcare workers about the patient condition so that they can take evasive action on time. And it has got a battery, inbuilt battery, that is lithium ion battery, which provides more than 2 hours backup. So because of all these advantages and the special features, this is an ideal equipment which can treat about 80 to 95% of symptomatic COVID-19 patients effectively. The contact details and the address of Apollo Computing Laboratories Private Limited is flashed on the screen. So all I can say is that let us all work together to save as many lives as possible. Thank you.